Hello, Finn.
Hey, nice to meet you.
Good. I'm Bill. How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. Welcome to Sonova AODC. Glad to have you here this afternoon.
It's great to be here.
Yeah, good. So I know a big part of your goal today is to get a little insight on what we do, how we make hearing aids and that. So how about if we just start at the top? I'll show you the place.
All right. Let's do it.
All right. Let's go. This is the beginning of the process. This is our receiving area.
All right.
So every morning we have FedEx and UPS who deliver all the orders from audiologists that they've been sending to us. So they're dropping off like 5,000 packages every morning. This is what we call order entry. They're taking the information that the audiologist has sent us for the order, and they're entering it into our manufacturing system, into our SAP system. That's the software we run our business on. This is what we're getting sent, is a set of ear impressions. You know about these guys, right?
Oh yeah, absolutely, yeah.
So this is the patient's impression that we've gotten for this particular order. The first step that we would have in the process when it's a new custom product is we're gonna scan those ear impressions. So let's go take a look at scanning those. At a scanning station, what we're doing is we're taking those ear impressions and we're putting them into a digital scanner. So those two gray boxes there are digital scanners. Translate that into data points. And then it's going to build on the screens. We'll be able to watch it do that. It's going to build what we call a point cloud.
So do that and basically remove the need for the physical mold already?
Once we've scanned it, then we don't need the physical mold.
Okay. So basically create the blueprint.
Yes.
Print it.
Next step in the process would be what we call modeling. The modeler is the architect of that particular hearing aid or ear mold or whatever it is they're making. That's the custom item. So they're taking the scan. They're taking all the order parameters that we've gotten in from whoever placed that order with us. And then they're gonna use this 3D based CAD software to design everything. So they're gonna place all the electronic components. They're gonna put in the right venting, the right.
It's gonna take incredible skill to line it all up.
Absolutely. So once this process takes place, the next step for that order is to go to actual 3D printing. So let's go take a look at that. We're gonna kind of loop around and go over here. So all these machines you see, the ones with the orange cones on them or the tall black rectangular ones, these are 3D printers.
Okay.
Sitting right here, you can see there's a kind of a tray. That's a glass tray and it's filled with liquid acrylic. Mm-hmm. Then there's a little armature there and you see the thing looks like a tray. You're kind of holding a tray like this. That's the build platform where we're actually going to print the shells on. When a print run is done, now these are just sort of dummy test ones, but this is what it looks like when they come out. So that's what's been printed by the 3D printer. And so Finn, I'm going to show you how we make our BTE ear molds, the ones that are soft materials. We first use the 3D printer to build a cast. So that's the shape of that person's ear. It's just like you were going to build a shell. And then what the technician is going to do is going to take the silicone pump and they're going to pump soft silicone material into that. The next step in the process, it's going to be just like cracking a hard-boiled egg. They're going to essentially crack away the outer shell, and then what will be left is the finished silicone ear mold. So if we want it to be multicolored, we have to inject a little
different
purple
mold,
a little of this, a little of that. And if we want to make one with glitter, the technicians literally hit the spoon glitter in there and, kind of mix it in and all that, but.
Yeah, that's really interesting to see the difference. Like the one 3D printed, the other one you have to fill it with mold.
Yep. The next step in the process is we have to put a serial number on them, right? Mm-hmm. Because we have to be able to identify them. The way we get the serial number onto the product is by using these lasers. You can take a closer look and you can see that's now the serial number is put into the system.
That's exactly how mine look now.
Yeah?
Yep.
So. After this step in the process, all these yellow bins you see on the shelves, those are all filled with hearing aid parts. Mm-hmm. So microphones and receivers and faceplates and all kinds of different things. And then each order is going to take a stop here because what we're going to do is pick parts that need to be put in with that order as it flows through so that when it gets to the technician that's actually going to work on it, they have all the parts and pieces. When it comes to the RICs and the BTEs, as I said, we don't manufacture them from scratch here, but we do final assembly. So we get all the parts and pieces in little bags. You see all the stuff in the trays?
Yep.
The little screws, the little, there's just all the various parts and pieces that are in there. And what our technicians will do is simply put all that stuff together. All right, so we're gonna go back over and we're gonna kind of start following the path of how we would finish building a custom hearing aid. Okay. The first step when it comes to that is what she just took out of that little protective envelope we call a faceplate. So see how all the electronics are on the back of that?
Yep.
We call it a faceplate because that's the part that you're going to see on the, sticking out of your ear. That faceplate gets loaded in just a minute here into this laser. So you see how that's perforated now?
Yeah.
So that's where the laser cut the exact shape. And it stays in around the rest of the faceplate until it gets to the technician that's going to work on it. And then they're just going to pop it out and it'll be ready to go. So the next step in the process is going to be what we call wiring. These technicians are now going to solder components on or off depending on what that particular order needs.
I could never do it.
you and me both. This is, you need the hand-eye coordination, you need the you need patience. The next step in the process we call closing. So closing means the faceplate with all the electronics is going to be mated up with the shell, and everything is going to be, that faceplate will be glued onto the shell, everything will be fit inside. They'll add receiver tubing and vent tubing and open it, attach everything into place. So you'll notice everybody's got something that looks like a stethoscope around their ears, so they're all doing a listening check. They want to make sure they're always listening to it to know whether or not what they did it do anything to kill it, right? To short it out or anything.
Is that something
like
that happened often or not really?
Not too often, but that's part of our quality control all along the way. Then we get to two cosmetic steps. So this area we call, like the sign says up there, cut, trim, and sand. So what these technicians are doing is they're starting to do cosmetic work. They're buffing the shell. They're making sure where we glued that shell and faceplate together that it has the right bevel angle on it, and so that it's going to fit well and look good that way. Every product that we're going to that's going to be built that's new is going to have a coating of clear lacquer put on it. So that's what is going to be done here. Now we have a finished product, but it has to go through quality control checks. So we have two formal steps of quality control. The first step we call listening and visual. So every one of these hearing aids now is going to get an individual inspection. They're going to do a listening check. You can see now she's going to look at everything. Does it look good? Does it work right? Check the battery compartment. Does it open and close? So what we're seeing here, this is electroacoustic testing. So when a hearing aid is finished, we have to make sure that it's working now electrically, acoustically, it's getting the right gain, the right output, the right frequency response, all of that stuff. So these test boxes are used to do that. Test box is going to generate a bunch of different signals, right? And it's going to test back for harmonic distortion, frequency response, gain, output, etc. And all of that happens automatically. If that hearing aid passes this test, it'll automatically get programmed with the audiogram of that patient.
Okay.
Right? So, and when I say that it'll get programmed, it'll do a first fit. So it's going to set the original parameters for gain, output, frequency response right now before we send it back out to to the office that ordered it. If it fails here, right, because this is quality control, so if it fails, we don't want it to move forward.
Yeah.
So it will automatically lock it out from the next step. It won't it move forward, and then we kind of send it back offline, and they have to figure out why did it fail, what's wrong with it. So this is the first place, although the door just got opened for us, this is the first place that we've come through where something's been locked away, right?
Yeah.
And the reason why we have to do that is because in this place, you can see all around you, this is where we keep all the parts, the pieces, all the finished goods. So everything in here are finished hearing aids, accessory items, all that stuff. And this, most of this we've taken in from our other factory. After we would final fill these orders and get all the things like user guides and all the other parts and pieces in there, we actually have a little bit of high-tech equipment that helps us in our shipping process. We feed a box into the conveyor belt. What happens is it comes by this printer, and the printer puts a barcode on the box, right? That box rides up to the top of the conveyor. This is what we would call a packing station. So finished orders are going to be brought up to the packing station. And what these guys are going to do is they're going to take the order, they're going to pack it up. they're going to add Tootsie Rolls to the box. Do you know about that?
No, I've never gotten Tootsie Rolls.
Okay, well, you wouldn't necessarily get them directly, okay. But it's just a tradition for us, kind of a fun, nice little thing. We throw a couple of Tootsie Rolls in the box, and then that box is sealed, and it's placed on the bottom of the conveyor. And then if we watch this one come by, and it's going to read the barcode on that box, and then it's going to move it forward, and then it's going to automatically print the label that's needed on that box to ship it out. And then that box, if we quickly look over here, if you watch, there's going to be paddles in there that are going to kick it to one side or the other. This one will kick down here. And this side is for shipping by UPS, the other side is for shipping by FedEx. And then all day long, as those boxes are finished packing, all these blue bins that you see here are getting filled up with those boxes. And then our good friends from FedEx and UPS, they're here all afternoon, just like you see that gentleman doing. He's grabbing the boxes, scanning them, so that now they can take them, yep. Put them on their trucks, and send them on their way. So. So that's kind
of... Life of a hearing aid.
Life of a hearing aid.
So before we get there, how long did it take for a hearing aid to come through this whole process?
Oh, that's a great question. So so we call that turnaround time. How long does it do it? On average, because if you think about it, we're not working on just one hearing aid at any one time. But we would tell our customers, our audiologists, it takes about 2 days to turn around a hearing aid from start to finish. Uh-huh. Sometimes people ask the question this way: if we were only going to work on one hearing aid, right, the whole place was just focused on one hearing aid, how long would that take to get that from start to finish? That process would be somewhere around 3 hours, if you think about by the time we model, print the shell, do all those things, but we would be able to move one through, if it was just one, in about 3 hours.
Thank you so much for the tour. That was just wonderful.
Ben, I loved having you here because you're interested in I know it affects your life, but you asked some of the better questions anyone's ever asked me, so it's cool. You really were into it. So
yeah, thank you very much. I can't believe this is such an awesome experience to see. This is the plant where my hearing aid came from.
Yeah.
Nope. These are the people that helped change my life.
Yeah. Well, I'll tell you what, we're glad we're part of that, so thank you.
Yeah, well, thank you very much.
Thanks for your time.
All right,
you take care. See you. Bye.